Hi everyone. I know you're probably thinking, you know, Nancy, I know you like Halloween. We've seen you dress up every video in October. But you know, Nancy, it's November. I know. Isn't that the most amazing thing? It's November, the first Friday in November, the first week is over in November, and here I am in costume. I know, but you know what? It's all good. It's Friday. Anything goes on a Friday. You've heard of Casual Friday? How about Dress Up Friday? I know, that would be something simple, right? Something silly. But anyway, I am opening up one of my Halloween themed wines that I bought that I didn't get to open last month, so we're going to do it this month. This is a really fun bottle. It's Chroniccellars. I had one of these already this year. I think I opened the one, but I didn't realize that if you do that little QR code in the back, you get like an augmented reality when you focus on this label. So I tried to do that earlier on my cell phone, and I tried to get a video of it, so we will see how that goes. But anyway, let's get this poured. It's Friday. I'm so excited to see you guys. I'm ready to have some dinner and wine, and I hope that you guys are here to join me. Hi everyone, I'm Nancy. Welcome to my home, welcome to my channel, and welcome to another Friday night Wine Diaries. Oh, we're having some Halloween wine. I just poured some into my glass because I forgot to bring in my aerator. So it is a nice deep purple. We're going to let it breathe in the glass a little bit. And we're going to tell you a little bit about the outfit that I'm wearing because, you know, yeah, it's a leftover. But anyway, so of course, you know, I've got this wig on. Worn it a few times. It's kind of one of, you know, it looks like it's a really weird wig when you first take it out of the package and put it on, but you've kind of fluff it up a bit, put a fascinator in, and you are good to go. So anyway, this is from Temu. These earrings, Temu. We've got these pearls on, these faux pearls. I think they're from Amazon. I really can't be sure. I've had them for me years. We've got this little boa feather, whatever. And does anybody else? I mean, every time I wear this, it's like for days I'm finding feathers everywhere. Yeah, it's annoying. Gloves, I think are from Amazon. The rings right here are from Shein. And the dress, it's another Charleston dress. It's got all these tassels. It goes almost to my knee. A little form, well, it's not really form fitting. It just doesn't flare out or anything. But if you were doing the Charleston, you were dancing, the tassels would be going every which way. So it just kind of makes it fun. I believe I got this from Amazon a few years ago. Alrighty, so I saved October 31st, my Ferrera. The 31-day countdown to Halloween, and proceeds of this went towards the Children's Miracle Network Hospital. And for the last day, October 31st, I got fudge stripes minis from Keebler, from those magical elves. So I'm going to enjoy having that. So anyway, last week I had made the big Panzella Stoup. It's a Rachel Ray recipe that you tossing like stale bread and things. So I had got that French or Italian loaf, and I used like half of that. I had it in the refrigerator to get it nice and stale. We made that nice stoup, and I had that. I think I had that last Friday. I took some of it, and I added more chicken broth. I added some frozen vegetables in there. I bought a pound of hamburger and a pound of sausage, and then I divided that in half. And then half of that went into my minestrone soup. Threw in a couple of noodles when it was done. I've already had that during the week. That was really, really good. So today, with the leftovers, I had already cooked up the ground beef and the sausage. I put that in with the Panzella. I didn't add any other chicken broth, but I did add a little bit more wine. I know. And then I added some noodles while it was cooking. And so it made kind of like what we used to call American Chop Suey. I don't know if you call that anymore. And then even though it's got plenty of bread in there, I have some garlic toast right here. And then I melted some mozzarella cheese on top. Yeah, so I love making that Panzella soup because I get to have the soup for a few days, then I divide it, and then I make a spaghetti sauce. Last year, I think I just had it with spaghetti and meatballs. This time I made it with a chop suey, and then I make that minestrone soup. So yeah, I'm gonna have to make some more because that's gonna last me a while. So that's gonna be my dinner. So for the wine, we are having the Chroniccellars. And it's a red blend. And like I said, I'm hoping that my video type thing worked on that. It is 14% alcohol. They say it's 70% Zinfandel. I think it was 20% Petit Syrah, 7% Syrah, and then 3% Grenache. So it should be an interesting combination. This is one of the deepest purples that I've seen in a while. It is coating my glass very nice, but it is 14.8% alcohol. It's probably one of the strongest ones I've had in a while. So I'm going to kind of stir it around a little bit more. I hope everybody had a fabulous week. Oh, we've had some cold weather here. I've had my heat on. I'm not happy about it, but you know what? It is what it is. I will have to cut back on something to pay for my heat. Cut back on wine, maybe? Who knows? You just never know. I can do it. Alrighty. But anyway, I hope you guys are having fun. I hope you're safe. We've had a little snow. We've had freezing rain. Most of the leaves are down. And yeah, it's getting to feel like winter. Alrighty, so let's take a sniff. I can definitely feel it right in here. And kind of like as you're breathing up, you can kind of feel the alcohol vapors. But it smells sweet. Could be black, maybe blackberries, blueberries, and cherries, or maybe just two of them. But I'm getting like a really sweet thing. When I think sweet, I always think blueberries, but it's so deep I'm thinking blackberries, because blackberries would give it this deep color as well. Sweet like cherry. Feels like cedar wood, like it was maybe aged in cedar barrels. Alrighty, ready? I'm going to have a sip. So anyway, I hope you guys had a fabulous week. I hope you have great, great dinner plans. Just fun with your family, your friends, your fur babies. Yeah, and here's to a terrific weekend. Cheers. This is nice and dry. I can still feel the sensation of the dryness up here at the top of my palate. I can even feel the dryness right here as it's starting to go down my throat. Back here, the glands just kind of clicking from the acidity from the fruits. Your mouth starts to water. Sorry for the spittle. And then those flavors just kind of come alive. It's definitely very, very fruity. It's got a smooth, it's got a rich body. You can feel the heat from the alcohol right in here too. Definitely aged in cedar barrels. And again, I don't know if it's blackberry, blueberry, and cherry or a combination of them, but it's also kind of not vanilla, but maybe like a mocha, like a chocolate and a coffee kind of mixed in here, which kind of softens everything as well. Gonna have another quick sip. Yeah, this is, it's nice and fruity. It's sweet from the fruits, but it's not overly sweet. You just get that dryness. You get the richness of it. You get the essence of all the fruit. Definitely like a chocolate or a mocha that's in here, or coffee, something like that. I'm thinking probably mocha. I'm thinking it's a blend, but I'm not sure. But again, it's just a really nice, smooth sipping wine. I can see having this with a nice pizza or a nice steak. Or American Chop Suey. And we're just going to have a little bite here. Yeah, I love that Panzella soup. It is so, so good. And because you get to do multi things with it too. So anyway, here, I'm going to have a bite. It's a big bite. Love the combination of the hamburger and the spicy sausage that I used. I used Italian spicy sausage. Sometimes if I know I'm having other people over, I might just buy mild or the sweet. I prefer the hot. It just kind of gives it another flavor as well. Gonna have another quick sip to wash it down. So good. So anyway, I want to thank you guys so much for spending part of your Friday night with me. It means the world to me. I just, you guys rock. I have just been so blessed. I've had so much fun on YouTube last month dressing up in costumes. I'm looking forward to doing the Vlogmas. I might have to have another ugly sweater contest. What do you guys think? Do you think I've got some new sweaters that might rival my last year's winner? We'll have to wait and see. But anyway, thank you guys so much. I hope you guys go out. Have a fabulous Friday night. Have a great weekend. Stay safe, everybody. Take care. Stay safe. Be kind. Be happy. Enjoy life. Have some fun. I love you guys so much, and we will see you in our next video. Bye-bye.
Paradise, and I'll be your impossibly charming host today. Yeah, I added that charming bit myself. I got this game of dice made just for us. I promise it's not rigged or anything. Trust me. The game is called Over Under. Here's my spiel. To start, guess the total of the two dice. Then I'll roll, and if you guess correctly, I'll drop some chronic knowledge on you. If you guess wrong, well... yikes. Wait, what? They said I was going to win this one. Okay. Here's my spiel. Chroniccellars hails from Paso Robles, the new Wild West of California wine. We're a bunch of rule-breaking outlaws, just like Paso's original founders. We're a little weird, and we like it. Okay, redemption round. Let's roll. Over or under six. Check out those skills. Never doubted for a second. Okay, it's your turn. Let's drop the wine snobbery. Spill a time you proudly ditched stuffy wine etiquette. Like, maybe you snuck that Cabernet into a coffee mug last Tuesday. It's cool. We like the creativity. Now click share, type your moment, tag your crew, and add hashtag Chroniccellars. I'll repost my favorite and send the winner a snazzy Chronic prize. Want to play again? Cue the replay button. Remember, we're still using my dice.